Playtime's over. We got 2 weeks to wrap up these Okada bikes. We're gonna have to be working nonstop in order to get these bikes assembled and shipped so that they're there in time for New Year's Eve.
Not only do we have to build an entire other bike from scratch in only 2 weeks, we still have a lot of work left to do on the first Okada bike. We still need to put the front end on, finish the paint, and make sure the thing runs.
Bring it in, dude. Give me a hug.
I'll give you a straight arm.
Once the first bike was in a good place, it was a complete rush to get the second bike done. We had to put the bike into a complete rolling chassis, get the wheels on, front end all mocked up, and get our ride height correct. After that, I had to start on the fabrication of the gas tank and all the tins. Once we get the tank and fenders back from paint, we can finish assembly and then put some gas in it and fire it up.
You know, it was a rough go, but my guys pulled through. Both bikes came out really good, and we got it done. So we finally landed at the airport in the Philippines after a 22-hour flight. And now we walk into Okada Resort. And that's where we're going to be unveiling the bikes.
Hello.
Get in there. Don't say anything stupid.
How are you?
Don't insult anybody.
Hello. Well, Paul Senior, Johnny, Mikey finally arrived at our hotel. That's very exciting for us.
Thank you so much.
All right, shall we show you to your room?
Dude, this is bigger than my house. I've been around the world, and I've never seen a place like this. Even the toilet wants to talk back to me, right? Yeah, most of the places that we do go to are, you know, pretty simple. You know, a bathroom, a bed, and a that doesn't open on its own.
Ladies and gentlemen, the one and only Paul Senior and the co-chopper! Oh, man!
The unveil of the first bike went great. We rung in the new year, saw some fireworks, but we're not done yet. We still got to reveal the second bike, and Mikey's gonna help me out unveiling the Cove bike.
Can you kick that kickstand up? Thank you. I'm kind of nervous about riding the bike up on stage. The bike's a little awkward, and so am I, so, you know.
I'm proud of my guys. They work 7 days a week. It shows their loyalty and their dedication, which is really important to me. The bikes look great, and the client's really happy, and that's all that's really important.
First, Happy guys. New Year, everybody.
Yo.
Hey, what's going on?
How much were you doing?
No, just sitting here at my shop.
I got a bike here that we did together
a long time ago.
Okay.
And it's a little worse for wear, and I just wanted to see if you wanted to come down here, and I wanted to get your thoughts on it.
I was actually a little nervous to even call him. I really want to do a project with him, and I feel like I don't want him to say no, even if it's not like big hugs and high fives right out of the gate. I'm hoping to get any kind of movement in the right direction.
I'll come down here in a little while.
Okay.
All right.
See you in a little bit. Bye.
Hey.
What's up? What you got there?
What do you think of this beast?
Oh,
to blast from the past. Oh.
Right?
What, did somebody throw rocks at it?
They beat it with a sledgehammer.
The bike was really destroyed. You know, it seemed like somebody intentionally did it. I was taken back. I mean, you know, I had to look at it for a while because I really didn't know what to say.
What a bunch of morons.
Right? All these signatures. Good? You remember Michael got all those signatures? All the whole Yankees team from 10 years ago.
Yeah, this was my mom's favorite bike for sure.
I know.
The first thing that I thought about is that we built that bike and how my mom was so excited about that. She was the hugest Yankee fan that there ever was.
I mean, someone like malicely destroyed this
thing.
Yeah,
I mean, they weren't even, I mean, it's just blatantly obvious.
You know, what I had in mind was restoring it completely, but even more importantly, what I was hoping is that maybe me and you can do this as a restoration project. I don't know, just to try and have something to do together.
Yeah, I mean, we could do it right here.
You know, his response was a short pause, which, you know, got me a little nervous because I'm like, oh no, he's going to get shot out of the sky. But after a minute, you know, he said, yeah, I'll do it. And, you know, he's willing to do it with me, and that's huge. For me, it's huge.
Let me get back to the shop.
Go back and see what programs you might have.
I'll go see what I have.
Maybe talk to Jason or something, see what you got.
Yep.
The Yankees bike in some ways represents our relationship and how damaged our relationship has been. What an opportunity to actually physically repair this and at the same time hopefully begin to repair our relationship. And I think it's something we really need. It's something I need, I know that. And I think whether he knows it or not, I feel like it's something he needs. Okay,
all
good,
right,
good. I'm glad. I'm glad we're doing it. Right, I appreciate it.
Yeah, I'll call you later.
Okay.